In the previous video, we learned about bifunctor. We saw bifunctor is a type of functor that operates on two type parameters instead of one. In this video, we will look into bifunctor in practice. All right, let's just start by importing the things that we need. So, HKT2, kind2, URIS2. If this looks new to you, I have a dedicated demo video of how to implement these things. So we already have this. I'm just importing those. If you need a refresher, please check out those videos. We also need to import either stuff. So either left, right is left. And I have a video on either as well. After importing everything that we need, let's define bifunctor type class. So interface bifunctor. Let's add the boilerplate code. We know bifunctor has a bimap method, so let's define that. Bimap is a generic function that works on four generic types. So let's show them by A, B, C, and D. It first receives two functions, function f from A to C, and function G from B to D. It then receives F of A and B, which is a structure of any kind, two or more. Apply F and G on it and returns F of C and D. As a refresher, HKT stands for higher recommended type and number 2 for any kind of 2 or more. If this sounds new to you, please check out my videos on type class and higher recommended types. Because of TypeScript and the way we modeled higher recommended type, we have some boilerplate code to write. So let's define interface for each kind. So bifunctor 2, F extends URIS2, meaning all the structures of kind 2. We have URIF and then bimap. Again, same as our previous interface. G. Now, instead of HKT2, we specifically want to implement this for kind 2. A and B. Kind 2 F, C and D. What about the structures of kind 3? We need to define another interface. Bifunctor 3, F extends URIS 3 for kinds 3, and so on. I'm not going to write all these interfaces and boilerplate code in this video, but you get the idea. Next, let's implement bifunctor instance for either. So either bifunctor is of type bifunctor 2, because either is of kind 2, equals to URI either. And now let's define bimap. So bimap first receives two functions. It then receives FAB and it should return FAC. In order to do that, let's pattern match over FAB. So FAB, in case of left, we want to call F with that value and then wrap it again in left. In case of right, we call G with that value and wrap it in right. And since FAB is happening on both sides of our equation, we can cancel them. And this is either bifunctor. Let's try this with a bunch of examples. Let me create a little bit of space here. First, let's define a bunch of functions for our examples. So let's define is email function, which receives a string and returns Boolean saying if the input is an email or not. So is email of type is email. It first receives a string, and we're going to simply say our string is a valid email if it includes @. For our next function, let's define to a string. It receives a number and returns a string. Const to string of type to string. It first receives a string. And the way we're going to show this as a string, let's do it like this. We say number and x. Now let's use our either by functor to lift is email into a string. So const lift one, either by functor dot bymap, and we're going to use our is email and to string functions. Let's try this, lift one, and I'm going to try this with left of, for example, bob@email.com. Let's console log this. And if I save, we see left of true because bob@email.com is a valid email. Let's also try this with a right value, so 12. And if I console log this, if I save, we get right of number 12 as a string. Now let's play with either by functor using id function. Let's create a little bit of a space here. So id is a function that returns whatever it receives as is, without any changes. So id of type id, it receives x and returns x as is. Let's define our lift2 function by lifting id and toString. Let's try our lift2 with left of bob@email.com. And if I console log this, let's save. We see left of bob@email.com with no changes. If we try this with right of 12, console log right 12. If I save, we get right of number 12. So our lift2 only converts the right value and keep the left value as is. If you remember, this is actually how the map function in either functor was working. In other words, bifunctor is actually a functor that works with the structures with at least two type parameters. For our next example, let's define lift3, but this time let's swap the place that we are using id. So this time let's have is email here and id on the right. If we try lift3 with left of bob@email.com, and let's wrap this in console log. If I save, we get left of true. But if we try this with right of 12, if I save, we get right of 12. So this time, lift3 is converting the left values and not the right ones. Since we could map over left and right of either type parameters, we say either is functorial on both of its type parameters. As a matter of fact, we can go and rename lift2 to map and lift3 to maybe map left. So map maps over the right type parameter of either, and map left maps over the left type parameter of either. Let's create a little bit of a space. So let's keep it here. And for our last example, let's try to have ID on both sides. So const lift for either by functor that my map, and we use ID for both sides. What happens if we call our lift for with left of bob@email.com? Let's console log this. If I save, we get left of bob@email.com. And if we try this with lift for right of 12, and if I save, we get right of 12. So our lift for function here doesn't change either of left or right values. It returns whatever it receives. In other words, it behaves like ID. And with that, thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.